going on, Crossroads? How you doing tonight? I don't think that's gonna cut it. I think like that microphone, that was a little bit of a quiet clap. I'm gonna need so much more energy and so much more clapping because you guys are in for a treat tonight. You are gonna see two of my best friends in comedy. They have treated me so well, they're gonna treat you so well tonight. They are gonna perform at the Tropicana in a few weeks here in a competition in the finals. That's how funny they are. Yeah, that's how funny they are. They perform up and down the East Coast. They go to colleges all over the place. Brought to you by GardenStateComedy.com. I want to hear you blow the roof off for Cardi and Madonna.
Good evening. Thank you, Mr. Bumper Car.
Only one correction on Natty's intro. We are McDonald and Carney.
I like what he did there. Did you see the rousing applause that we got with Carney and McDonald? Let's stick to it.
Who likes McDonald and Carney?
Who likes Carney and McDonald? We'll go with Carney and McDonald. So he's like, oh, now I gotta make up a whole bunch more posters.
This is unbearable. Thank you, Joe. Thanks, everybody, for being here.
Yes,
we appreciate it.
Give it up for Generic Brand Human. They're filming us tonight, so you guys look all pretty and everything. Wait for the camera. Generic Brand Human is in the house. Thank you, guys. They take care of all of our stuff. This is going to Hollywood, people, so look good, okay?
If you need a picture with us, take it tonight. You'll never see us again.
Right, yes.
Any of us.
Don't plan on hanging out with any of you after the next couple of weeks.
No.
And we dropped Ted, so everything's going splendidly. Right, buddy? We're mic'd up, sorry.
Oh, he's going to see this on HBO. Listen, what Joe and I do, we've been doing this for years, and we've been coming to this point. What we do is compete with World Cup, because we do this every night. World Cup comes once every 4 years.
Right.
We do improv.
Improv.
Stand-up comedy.
Stand-up comedy.
We wrote some sketches for them tonight.
Movies.
Maybe a song or two.
TV. Internet. We've done everything. Why are we performing for them?
We're so above this room.
It really is. I don't even realize what they get to gaze upon. No, but for real, Rich and I have been performing together for like 3-4 months now.
We've been doing it a couple years. A couple of years now,
okay. Rich and I hadn't met ever before that, nor have we ever done stand-up or any sort of improv before that.
We've been doing a lot of stuff together.
We have been doing?
Yeah.
We even dress the same.
Wow, we have a heckler, people.
I'm so thankful you're here. I mean it.
Which is weird because I told you the show was tomorrow.
Rich and I actually met while we were acting.
It was an improv class.
You told me I was funny.
I thought you were an ass.
Ah, yes. I remember it well. Bob was our director.
It was Ted.
The funny looking one.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Ah, yes. I remember it well. You like my set.
I think you're a hack.
I named you Big Rich.
You only call me Mac.
Ah, yes. I remember it well. You said we were funny.
I said we were pretty.
We performed in Vermont.
And Atlantic City.
Yes.
I remember it well.
We've got films in Cannes.
No, it's Hoboken.
I told you we'd be famous.
And you weren't joking.
Yes.
We remember it well.
How was that for a good? That was pretty good.
It was called like a song, and we made up the words.
I didn't even know that was coming. You and I now we like finish each other's
sentences. It's really kind of
weird.
Oh my
God!
Stop.
We even dress
the same.
Guys, what do you say we stop with the shenanigans and get this show rolling?
You want to play an improv game?
I would like to play an improv game.
Where we make
it
up?
Who knows how improv works? You guys been here before?
Never.
Those not related to us. Have you been here before?
Pretty much talking to them.
No.
Okay, how improv works is we are going to make you guys a part of this show. You guys are going to throw out suggestions. You're going to give us lines. You're going to make fun of us. Sometimes we're going to call you up on stage. You're going to sit in these chairs, some of you, every once in a while. When we ask you for a question, just shout it out. For instance, sir, with the hat, chewing, looking right at me. I'm going to get you while your mouth is full. If I ask for a vegetable, what are you going to yell out? Siskel, what's that?
Christopher Reeve.
He wouldn't do that.
Never.
He wouldn't do it. He wouldn't do it. He's gone. He's
ask
gone.
Him again.
There's so many new vegetables.
Ask him again.
Your favorite movie, sir?
Dumb and Dumber.
Dumb and Dumber. Was that a dig? Was that a dig?
I don't understand. Which one am I?
Dumb. Ma'am, your favorite movie?
Godfather.
Godfather. She's seen the show. Okay. Sir, what's your favorite movie?
Braveheart.
He gets to go to all the shows. Okay. Miss, what's your favorite movie?
Frozen.
Frozen?
Never heard of it.
It's kind of big. Gotta have kids, not date them. Sir, favorite movie?
Jaws.
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 Like a Steven Spielberg film.
Like a Steven Spielberg film, yeah.
If you don't look at us, we're still gonna pick on you. This is the way
it's like
it works.
Jurassic Park. He's like, if I don't look at them, if I don't look at them. What's your favorite movie?
Grease.
Yes, it is.
Very, very. Grease is the word.
Is the word?
Is the word. Yep.
It's a word.
Miss, chatting it up. What's your favorite movie?
A Fish Called Wanda.
Never mind. sir. Mr. McLaughlin Report, what is your favorite movie? He doesn't have a favorite movie.
Ooh, those are the best. Where do I
keep date? Right there.
All right, here's what we need. We need a volunteer, but we need a specific volunteer. We need an Indian woman in her late 20s.
Where the hell are you gonna find Cher?
Ritu, would you like to join us on stage?
I thought you meant Native American. They don't like to be called Indians, buddy. The whole football thing.
What? Let's give her a round of applause. Now, you're going to stand right here in front. This is a microphone. What it does is it expands your voice so everyone can hear you. I want you to hold these. These are the movie styles suggested by our good-looking audience.
Right.
We're going to play a game called Movie Styles, where we start a scene, and at some point, Joe or I will yell freeze. And our lovely volunteer will yell out the next movie style or movie. And we'll continue that scene and that style until we get through your paper or we do something funny and we say that's enough.
Okay. You'll know.
You'll know. When you hear something funny, you'll be like, that's it.
Okay.
All right.
One more question I think we have for them, right?
Yes, we have one more question.
Okay. Some place where people work, a busy place where people work. Yell it out. Disney World is the resounding answer that I heard. Disney World?
Disney
amusement
World.
Park. It's an amusement park.
It's amusing.
Amusement park. Ready?
All right.
Okay. Step right up, step right up. See the biggest, best ride in the world. Ooh, what do you got there?
I got a giant soda.
That is the biggest soda I've ever seen. You obviously don't live in New York. Come here, buddy. You want to see the lady who's got claws for hands, beard for hair?
She sounds out. Is she single?
She's single for you, my friend. How many tickets you got left?
Let me check right here. How many does that get me?
That'll get you in the door. Step right up over here, my friend. Come right over the rope. Come right up. You're the first one in line.
Freeze.
Freeze.
So, I don't know what the word that you've heard that you've heard that you've heard. They're right here. This is the Yak Woman. She's a hell of a cook.
The one over there?
The one over there.
The one over there? The one over there?
Oh, it's freezing.
The
in
one
here.
Over there?
I got chills.
Oh my God, they're multiplying.
And I'm losing control.
Perfect power, you're supplying.
How would you define it?
It's electrifying.
You better shape up.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Cause I need a man.
He needs a man.
Look at, what just happened? It's that damn cold in here. Listen, this is Goat Boy. He's the, he's our newest attraction right here.
He's half man, half
goat.
Freeze.
Godfather.
He wasn't sure if he was gonna come to the carnival. We had actually asked him several times. And then my associates made him an offer that they could not refuse.
Daddy, I'm smart. I'm smart. I can see things. I'm smart.
Why don't you do me a favor and act like a man? Do you know that goats can smell fear?
There are things. You send me over there where there's no goats. You send me over there.
There was no way that you were doing two cocktail waitresses at the time.
Dad, I don't understand what you're saying.
I was going to take this and I was going to open this up in the desert, a stopover for GIs coming home from the war. I was going to take this nice little carnival and you're going to ruin it.
Dad, what's wrong with your chin?
It's so freaking cold in here, my bed is crazy. Did I tell you I had chills?
They're Freeze. Multiplying.
Jim Carrey movies. Jim Carrey movies, is that?
Oh, Jim Carrey movies.
Jim Carrey movies.
Freeze.
Braveheart.
I knew it was next, lad. Have I told you that I love you? I've always loved you. I'm going to marry you.
What do you wear under that skirt?
It's my shoes. Listen.
Why don't you wear underwear?
A true Scotsman never wears underwear, lad. Just his shoes and a smile. It's the only way. Hey, your parents are coming. Don't let
freedom!
Them see
you. Freedom! Freedom!
That's actually why I don't wear any underwear, lad. It's for freedom, really. Freedom to move about as I'd like.
Okay. I'll marry you.
You will? I just want to go for a ride on my horse. You want to marry me already? You're kind of easy, you know.
There's and not much to do besides throw rocks.
It actually is freezing in here, isn't it? Button up, freeze.
Frozen.
It is freezing in here. It's like so cold. I just want to let it go.
No, that's perfect. You have more tickets? Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go. Let it go! So this is our winter wonderland right here in the carnival.
Okay, it seems cold.
It snows in here 24/7.
What about weekends?
Freeze!
Steven Spielberg.
Goat Boy.
Actually.
Phone home.
It's actually time to phone home. My wife was telling me that I was late for the... It's actually Thursday night. My wife makes mashed potato mountains at...
Fun home.
Why do you smell like Reese's Pieces?
Freeze.
Freeze.
Cheap date.
Ladies and gentlemen, give her a round of applause. Thank you. Get back.
That was so mean. You didn't even see it coming.
No, she did delightful. That's not fun. That's a, we're so tough.
Want to bring some people up?
Yeah, let's do a sketch first.
Well, Rich, I finally get to go to a New York Mets game with you, pal.
I'm glad you did that, Joe. Appreciate it.
Even though you know I'm not a Mets fan.
I know this.
I'm actually a New York Yankees fan.
We're well aware.
I couldn't even name some of the players on this Mets field, my friend.
Wow, really? That's surprising. Well, I'll tell you the truth, I could tell you the name of every ball player out there.
I hear players nowadays, they got some weird names.
Oh, that's the thing. Each ball player's got, I would say, peculiar names.
Funny names?
Yeah, strange names. For example, what are you getting, a text message?
Yeah, it's from my daughter here. Kids nowadays, they only talk in text message. Half the times, I don't even know what they're talking about.
Nah, that they do. They're crazy. If you need help, just let me know.
Okay.
But I'll tell you about the ball players on the field.
Okay.
Over there on first base, we got who is texting you now, Joe?
These damn text messages. I can't understand half the words they're saying. You help me out if I ask you some of these text message questions?
Listen, I'm here to help you out no matter what.
You promise? You're not going to make fun of me?
Joe, do I ever make fun of you?
Well, you must understand high school text messaging. You date most of them.
That's only half true, but I'm here to help you. You tell me what you need, and I'm always there.
Thank you, pal. I asked my daughter what time she was going to be home, and she texted me back IDK.
Okay.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
That's kind of no help to me.
Hey, I'm doing my best.
You understand what this text means?
Of course I do.
You read what it says?
Yep, I see it right there.
She wrote back IDK?
Yes, she did.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
Oh. Not really sure why you're being so condescending. You said you were going to help me.
I'm here to help, Joe. You ask a question, I answer.
You're not helping me.
I think I'm quite the helper.
You see this text message?
Yeah, I see it right there on your phone.
You understand what it means?
Of course I do.
If I was to send you this same text message, you'd know what it means.
Of course. What am I, a moron?
So you'll tell me what it means when I ask you.
All you gotta do is ask, Joe.
It says IDK.
That's what it says.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
Okay. Really glad I came to the game with you today, Mac.
I am too, man. It's great to have you here.
Oh, yeah. You're real cute.
Two buddies, ball game, doesn't get better than this.
You're not going to help me.
I always help you.
I just sent her a text that said, what does IDK mean? She wrote back LOL.
Yeah, that makes sense.
What makes sense? That LOL means IDK?
Yeah, in this situation, I would say so.
If I ask you a question, you're going to bust my chops?
Joe, do I ever bust your chops?
Yes, you do a lot. You're going to make me look stupid in front of these people.
Would I do that?
So LOL means IDK?
Yeah, in this regard, it does.
What does LOL mean?
Laughing out loud.
Of course you are laughing out loud. Do you understand that these people are laughing at me? Do you understand what this means to me for the safety of my daughter?
Joe, I love your daughter. I would never let anything happen to her.
I'm trying to find out what time she's coming home and you're not going to help me. What do you mean you don't want anything to happen to her?
I'll help you in any way I can.
You promise.
Scout's honor.
No more busting my chops.
Would I ever?
You're not going to embarrass me.
No.
Let me ask you a question.
Go ahead.
Okay. Let's say your girlfriend sends you a text after homeroom.
Okay.
And she says you want to hang out tonight.
Sounds good so far.
And she writes back in a text.
That's how texts work.
She writes back, what time do you want to hang out?
All right.
And you write back, IDK.
Yeah.
You know what that means?
Of course, I wrote it.
You wrote it, you sent it, you know what it means.
That's how it works.
IDK.
Absolutely.
What's it mean?
I don't know.
I'm gonna kill you. I'm actually having palpitations. Do me a favor.
You gotta calm down.
I gotta calm down. I'm at a Mets game and I gotta know what time my daughter's coming home and you're not answering any of my questions.
I'm telling you everything I can. You gotta calm down. A person your age, this isn't good for your health.
My throat's gonna explode. I'm so angry with you right now.
Yeah, you shouldn't be. You gotta calm down. Breathe.
Do me a favor.
Breathe.
Let's call a truce.
I didn't know we were fighting,
Joe. We've been fighting for 5 minutes.
I didn't know we were fighting.
Let me ask you.
Okay.
From here on out, you're going to help me. You're going to tell me what all these text messages mean.
Of course, Joseph.
You promised me.
I promise.
I
Scout
sent
Sommer.
My daughter a text message that said I was going to chaperone her dance.
That's sweet of you.
Thank you.
You are a great dad.
I know that I am. She wrote back KMN. What's that mean?
Kill me now.
Because you won't tell me. Kill me now. I don't think you understand what you're doing to me. I don't know what time to pick her up. LOL means IDK. I have no idea where she is, what time she's coming home, and you're not answering any of my questions. Yep, you're going to sit here and watch the baseball game.
Yeah, it doesn't sound fair, does it?
It doesn't sound fair at all to me. Can I ask you a question now? You promise you're going to answer me.
I've been answering you all day.
You haven't been answering me. I don't know what you're doing. So I wrote back I was going to chaperone her dance, okay?
Okay.
Then I wrote back I love you.
That's sweet.
She wrote back TMI. What does that mean?
Too much info.
Wow! You got commitment issues! Too much information! I haven't said anything. I've asked you a question, TMI. What's it mean?
Too much info. Breathe, Joseph. Breathe. You've been doing good so far. Breathe.
I sent her a text right after that that said, what's your boyfriend's name? She wrote back, M-Y-O-B. What does it mean?
Mind your own business.
You tell me to mind my own business one more time. I'm going to take that hot knock glove and I'm going to stick it so far up your ass. Let me tell you one last thing. Do you know when I asked you this last question what I'm going to do to you if you don't answer my question?
I don't know.
Third base.
Thank you. We just made that all up in front of you. I hope you guys liked it. I'm glad we didn't practice.
We've been rehearsing it for like 3 weeks.
We do need, Joseph, two...
Two volunteers, two people who want to come up here and get on. You tell me.
I think soup. Angela, he knows I was talking to him. Let's
come
give them
up,
a round of applause.
Put your hands together for soup. And Angela, what's up, guys? Go over there by Big Rich. He's going to explain things to you.
All right. Well, there you go. We got the other one. Can it come through?
Yep. Go ahead. Explain it.
We're going to play a little game called Sound Effects. I have you gentlemen ever seen this game played? Yeah. Angela, you're going to follow along very well.
That's yours. That's
now
yours.
I'm going to tell you how it's played.
It's my show, kid.
We want you to be good, but not too good. You know what I mean? There's a scout in the back. We're going to perform a scene for you, and you guys are going to do the sound effects whenever we ask for them. Yeah, all right, relax, Soup. We know you're excited to be up here. He's ready to go. Now, Angelo, you're going to do the sound effects for Uncle Joe.
I don't know this kid. Everybody calls me Uncle Joe. Go ahead. It's your mom.
Yeah, thanks. When I say don't tell her the night of the show, don't tell her the night of the show. Is she underwater?
Pinocchio.
Now, let's say Uncle Joe says that he's about to do some tap dancing. All right, we didn't do the funny stuff yet, lady. Ronnie, get her out. All right, you ready?
Yeah.
You're going to make the sound effect. Not you! Can someone slip her a Valium? I will pay.
What's with Aqualung tonight?
It's like Toucan Sam and Chewbacca had a baby.
Chewie, shut up!
Now, this is for Angelo, and only Angelo. Now, you know, if somebody else takes over at midnight, we got to get through the show. Uncle Joe's going to start tap dancing. You're going to make the sound effects. Ready? Go. Give him a round of applause. That's how you do it.
Very well done. Very well done. Now you, my friend, you're going to make the sound effects for Big Rich over here, okay? I would say do a baseball bat, but it never makes a sound when he swings it. So what we're going to do is... let's say Big Rich reaches down into his bag and pulls out a gigantic machine gun and starts firing it up in the air. Or over there. What's it going to sound like?
All right, does anyone know the Heimlich? All right, so you guys get the concept. I think that'll be fine. Sir, the one who keeps getting redder as the show goes along, here's what I have to ask you. What's on your bucket list, something you've always wanted to do before you die? Something like skydiving, but not skydiving.
What if it was skydiving?
Because we get
it
every show.
He's like, I've always wanted to skydive. I got nothing else.
What's on your bucket list? Something you always wanted to accomplish?
Skydiving.
Fuck.
No,
forget it. Forget it.
Skydiving.
It's right there. And you took it away.
Are you really going to say skydiving? We will go with it. We are going with skydiving. Now, okay. I will ask somebody from this table, sir, right as you're eating.
Yeah.
We want to be two famous characters skydiving. Somebody over the top, larger than life, living or dead. Don't say my mother. She's not that funny.
Solo and Luke Skywalker.
Han Solo and Luke Skywalker.
Okay, I'm Han Solo.
Dibs.
And you guys are going to give us the sounds, right? When we call for him?
Ready?
I'm ready.
Hey, kid, you ready to go skydiving for your first time ever? Come on over here and help me open a door to the Millennium Falcon.
Why do you keep calling me kid? I can do anything you can do.
Put your little sword thing away and help me open the door.
I can cut right through the door with my lightsaber. Hold on, let me turn it on. Oh, listen to this.
That's actually pretty amazing, my friend.
I know. Who knew it dribbled water like that?
All I have is this photon blaster. Look.
I didn't know it's a flare gun.
It's a flare. Now Jabba's gonna know where I am. What? He knows what I'm gonna do. The gun just knows what I'm gonna do. I've had it for so long.
All right, hold on. I'm gonna put my lightsaber away. I'm gonna turn it off. It gets sad when I turn it off.
Do me a favor and help me open the door to the Millennium Falcon, please.
Sorry.
Turn that dial to the left. I'll turn this one to the right.
Why are the dials though so depressed?
Alright, pull on it really, really hard. It's gonna make a loud creaking noise. Now you know why we named it the Falcon.
It's like a million cats just screamed out in horror at the same time.
We closed the door on Chewbacca's foot.
Chewbacca drowned. I don't know if you heard it before the show.
Kid, do me a favor. Pull down the steps. Pull down the steps right on that handle.
It was more of a rolling step.
Yeah, it's a new thing that we just installed. It's like a Sunset retractable awning, but it steps. It's pretty damn cool. Actually, I have the remote right over here. Look.
Love the way it works.
Go ahead,
you know what?
First.
I'm a little nervous.
It's okay.
I always thought the first time I jumped out of a plane into space, there'd be music playing.
When we get inside, I'll put the music on. Go up the steps.
I keep stepping on nails.
Help me up. Pull me in. Pull me in.
Oh, now you need my help.
I'm going to jump.
Tough guy. That was my back.
You all right? All right, kid. You ready? This is a lucky day. We're going to fire up the Millennium Falcon. And I'm going to let you do it.
I thought it was Falcon.
If you're from Canada, we're from outer space. Turn the key on the Millennium Falcon.
Are you sure the battery?
That's the radio, dummy. The key's over there. Okay. You ready?
You like space jive music?
You ready? You feel the Millennium Falcon bouncing? All right, give it some throttle, kid. We're never going to make it to 3.21 parsecs. I love combining movies, my friend.
All right, we're cruising.
Ready? Did you hit the thrust? Give it one hard. Pull it forward. Push it. Take that, Millennium Falcon. Take that. Ready? We're gonna. Oh, it's gonna take off. We're going. I get really excited on these. All right, level out.
Okay. Was that the Great American Scream Machine? No, it's pretty sweet.
All right, do me a favor, man.
We gotta
get in the mode to jump out of the Millennium Falcon, okay?
All right. Like, I wanna get intense, I wanna get ready.
Turn on some music, let's see what's going on. Hopefully it's some metal.
Oh, yeah.
This is fucking awesome.
We should be cruising for chicks. I think that Leia girl is really hot.
That's space balls. Do me a favor. Come in the back with me, throw that on autopilot.
Hold on. You think they would have just put one button, you know what I mean?
No, it's a whole code thing. I never want Jabba to get this thing back. Now lock it in. Back here with me.
All right.
Do me a favor. Help me put on my parachute, and then I'll help you put on yours.
Wow, this thing's really heavy. Yeah.
Clip me in. Oh, you got skin. Back. Okay,
oh,
put yours
Joe.
On. Come up here. You okay?
Feeling good. Feeling good. I'm nervous.
All right, I'm gonna put yours on and clip it in. You ready? You're a little giggle puss. What are you, ticklish?
I grew up on a space farm.
Hold on, I'm just checking the buckle in the back. Now before we jump, we gotta get the two droids out of the back to take over the Millennium Falcon total lamp.
Okay.
R2-D2, C-3PO, come here!
I think it's broken.
No, it was actually designed that way.
I'm sorry. Oh wait, there's a hologram message.
Obi-Wan, you're our only hope. What is that?
Oh, it's Michael Myers. Okay, we're gonna... All right, they're gonna take over the plane.
Okay.
We're gonna jump, and when we jump, we're gonna jump.
Now listen, so when we jump, we're gonna jump.
Listen, follow with my logic.
When I crack open this door, do you understand that we're in outer space? Do you understand the gush of wind that's gonna be coming at us?
It's gonna knock my hair back.
You ready? Hold on tight, kid. You ready for this? Before we jump.
But when we jump, we're going to jump.
You ready?
I should tell you one thing, Han.
What?
I can use the Force, you can't. You guys did awesome.
You want to put these on and take over? You guys did great. Good job. Great. That's cute.
Give
it up for Soup and Angelo. Good job, guys. Good job. Awesome.
You got it. Oh God, we having a good time, everybody? How we doing? That's excellent, excellent. You look good. Yeah, I got this under control. That's good. Don't go changing your underwear, Joe. I don't know how that last scene.
Why would I start now?
Mrs. Carney. What's with him?
I don't know.
No, seriously. Like, what's he? Where did it go wrong? Yeah. You know, I was doing a show.
Sorry about that. It's important. Whisper in your eyes. Blue little pools of sweetness.
In the middle of a show.
I know, but it's important. Come here. Can you smell like honey, too?
Well, that's accurate. All right, yeah. I'll make this real quick.
Just sorry, everybody.
Sorry for the interruption. I guess the Garwood police just came to the door and gave Natty a crime alert. Over the last couple of days, Union County has seen a rash of bank robberies, and there was one about 20 minutes ago outside. So they're just letting you people know to be safe when you go to your cars. The suspect who's been performing these bank robberies has hit many, very vicious, very violent. So they just wanted to spread the word, and if you guys see them. The other thing, it says if you do come in contact with the aforementioned suspect, it's, well.
Calm down.
You are sick.
Ma.
At least I look halfway decent. I gotta
Ma, if you needed money, you should have came to one of your other kids.
I was gonna say not you, the other one is here.
Mom, why do you do this stuff?
Give it up for Mrs. McDonald.
Guys, one of the cool parts of what Rich and I do is we actually like to include a little bit of snack.
Yeah, see?
Rich and I, I'm trying to time it, Rich and I like to include stand-up in this improv stuff that we do. We like to do sketch comedy, little improv, and we like to include a little bit of stand-up comedy. That's the cool part of the show. It's got a lot of variety, a lot of people like to come and enjoy it, a lot of people like to come see us doing this because they never know what they're gonna get. We did not know that Rich's mom was a bank robber. That really just came in from the police. Sick, sick lady. So just, I don't know if some of you know this, but I am a huge fan of the newfound problems that we're having with Russia, the fact that they just invaded the Ukraine. Anybody else in full agreement with me that we are invading Ukraine and that's a good thing? You raised your hand. I'm telling you, we have different reasons why. No, I'm just kidding. Guys, this is something that I have just become aware of. I love the fact that Russia has invaded the Ukraine so that Russia could not be the new bad guy like it used to be back in the 1980s, okay? Let me explain to you why. Do you guys remember Rocky IV? You remember Rocky IV? It's my favorite movie. And forever, I loved Rocky IV, and I like to act out movies. So for 2 weeks during the winter, I got to act out Rocky IV while it was in Russia. You know what I'm talking about? Okay? So I pictured every time Bodie Miller got to the top of the mountain, and he would ski down to the mountain, he would ski, he would get his gold medal, and Bodie Miller would get up on that stand, and they would give him his gold medal, right? And Bodie Miller would go, oh, when I got here, you guys didn't like me too much. But if I can change, and you can change. We can all change. Rocky, Rocky, Rocky. Great movie, great movie. You'll see it someday, I promise you. That was like for this audience over here. My wife says to me, she goes, why do you base everything in our lives on movies? And I went, I may not be a smart man, but I know what funny is.
Give Joe a round of applause. Joe likes to joke about his wife a lot, his act.
Yes.
And the fact she stays with you, God bless her. God bless. But we loved, do we have any married couples in the room? I will find you. You don't count. Oh, I saw, oh, look at that. Oh, you're married to each other. This is so awkward. We do need a married,
Shut up. I was recording.
We just happen to need a married couple for our next game. Joseph, where do you think we'll find a one that does not mind public displays of affection?
Come on up. Why don't you guys play with us? Come on. Let's sat right here for a reason. Sir, why don't you come on up and play with us?
This is just the seat they saved me.
Give them a round of applause.
What's your name?
Come on up.
What's your name?
Francisco.
Francisco? And what's your name?
Francesca.
Francisco and Francesca. I think they're full of shit. That's shit. Not when the kids are here. The game that we're going to play is called the couple game. Rich and I get to act out their life based on a couple of questions. Okay? How this is going to work is every time that we do something right, this young man is going to yell, ding. Let me hear you say ding. Let me hear your ding.
Ding.
Ding. Ding.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good. That's pretty good.
Francisco, very good. Francesca, every time we do something wrong, you're going to honk your horn. Not into the microphone. They can hear it. Okay.
So, Tim is fine.
For the first time ever, you get to be right, and she's wrong. Okay?
Okay.
So we're going to ask them a few questions, and we're going to act this out, okay?
A few basic questions. This is for the audience, as well as for us.
Are you married? You are married.
All right, that's it.
Do I ding?
No, not yet.
Ding.
Not yet. I'll let you know when you're supposed to ding. Don't ding while I'm donging.
So listen. Okay, you are married. Where did you meet?
Rutgers.
College.
College.
Okay.
Sure.
Rutgers College. Okay.
Sure.
I don't know if you, like, you were a cook and she was a janitor. You were in college.
Okay. They met at Rutgers.
Okay.
Just yes or no, do you have children?
Yes.
Have I seen one recently?
Yes.
What do you do for a living?
I'm a teacher.
Teacher.
I sell jewelry.
You sure? Because you thought of it
for a
minute.
Oh, I'm a bullshit artist. No.
I do stuff with things.
Teacher, jewelry, okay.
Where do you live?
Clark, New Jersey.
Clark.
Clark.
So okay. You flew in. This is nice to have you here.
It's a long and arduous journey.
Now, let me ask you, what do you love most about your wife? What do you love, that one thing that makes her unique?
She always remembers where she puts things.
I really did call up the wrong couple. Okay. What do you love most about him?
His sense of humor.
This is getting good.
That's the good one. That's the good
now,
one.
Now, if you could change one thing about your lovely bride, not that you want to change anything, but if you could change one thing, one little pet peeve, what would that be?
That she would remember where she was.
I'm seeing a theme.
You see what I'm saying? If you could change one thing about Ding, what would you change?
I'm sleeping with his mouth closed.
She said sleeping with his mouth closed. Sleeping with his mouth closed. She would like him to sleep. Okay.
So now we need anything else?
One, yeah, absolutely.
I think we're pretty good.
Young lady, who would you like to portray you?
You get the choice. Who do you think's more feminine?
All right, ready?
That means you're Ding.
I know.
Okay.
Follow my Ding.
This is going to be from the moment you met up until this very second.
So if I do something right, what's going to happen?
Ding.
If we do something wrong, what's going to happen? Okay.
So I'm like the biggest drinker on Rutgers.
I don't really like to drink that much.
Ding. Get me a drink.
Ding.
Get me another drink.
Ding it up.
What's your name?
Too good for you.
I'm here at Rutgers Teaching College, and I just wanted to know if you... I'm just here working as a janitor here at Rutgers. I decided I was just going to go poli-sci. Communication.
Ding.
I came down to the brass rail and here you were. Queens, here you were. You're my queen.
You know, I don't usually talk to guys at frat parties because you make... I talk to guys at frat parties all the time.
Ding.
Did I meet you last night? Or the night before?
Last night I was at I Tap a Kega.
Right. The more I drink, the more you're okay.
Listen, I was just wondering if I could stuff your face.
I didn't do that.
If the Stromboli's around the corner, would you like to go out on a date with me? Olive Garden? You want to just go out and have a good time with me?
Dang.
Oh God, you look so much different when I'm sober.
What? I thought I'd take you someplace expensive.
I thought you were taller.
You like gas stations? No, this place has unlimited bread and soup.
You're on that Olive Garden thing.
Actually, this is Chuck E. Cheese.
I used to work there.
You take me to the place you work on our first day. This is,
I have coins. You want to play skeet ball? Did I tell you how beautiful your eyes are?
Ding.
They look like diamonds.
Tell me more.
They look like diamonds.
Ding.
I like I like diamonds.
But I got to tell you one thing.
Your feet stink.
Ding, ding, ding. Ding, 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 ding.
Listen, I don't mean it in a bad way. I kind of like that.
Smell them. Smell them.
I can.
I can.
I knew you were here. Listen, we've been going out on so many dates, and yeah. I was just wondering, would you please marry me? Sometime down the road, maybe we'll go on another date?
I don't know. Ask again. Surprise me. Surprise me.
Okay. Will you please, please, please marry me?
Well, it's about time you asked.
Now, don't forget where the hell you put that. This goes here and it never comes off. You understand? See it, look at it, memorize it. That's where that goes.
Okay, I'll be back. Where did I put it?
Hey, where's your ring? Come on, we gotta get to the altar. I'm not supposed to see you.
But you did. But you did.
Oh, okay. This is the happiest day of my life.
Dang.
Mazel tov. Assalamu alaikum. I do.
Dang.
This is so awesome.
Dang.
Oh, and I love that you washed
dang.
Your feet.
Back room.
I love dang. That you washed your feet. You are so beautiful, my love. Where do you want to go on a
oh, I can't wait for our honeymoon.
Oh. Here we are in beautiful Aruba. Here we are in the Poconos. Is that your sister and brother-in-law?
Dang.
Are they really coming on our honeymoon?
I thought you would love it.
I only know the guy 4 months.
He's kind of a loudmouth, but once you get to know him, he's not so bad.
Why does everybody always say that about that guy?
If you don't like him now, give him some time.
Listen, you promised we're only going to stay here for like 5 days?
Well, if my sister's husband pisses us off, we can leave.
Okay. This is the most best honeymoon ever. I love going to Disney World with
Ting.
You.
Ting.
What's up? Oh my God. Are you pregnant?
I've been wanting to tell you, but...
On our honeymoon?
I'm pregnant.
Spin around once. Make it go in the future.
Look at us, 9+ months later.
Oh my God. What a...
Oh my God, I'm in labor. Pregnant? I'm in labor. I'm in labor. Don't help me. Don't help me. No. Don't help me. Don't help me. Oh God. Okay.
Push it out, shove it out, way out. Push him out, shove him out, way out. It's a beautiful baby boy. It's a beautiful baby girl. We should name him after my grandmother. We should name him after your grandmother. Your mother and my mother combined.
Wow.
Oh, look at us, a baby girl.
So beautiful.
We should just stop at one.
Absolutely.
Oh my God, I'm pregnant again. I'm in labor.
You sure?
Now.
Are you sure?
You've done enough. You've done enough. Go stand over there.
The head is crowning. It's crowning. Oh my God. It's Rudy Giuliani. Oh, he's beautiful, I think.
He's so cute.
Oh, wait. Oh, there he is.
Oh, thank God.
We should name him after your mom. Your grandfather.
Dang.
Oh,
put him over there with his sister.
Yeah, throw him over there.
Don't forget where we put him.
I really want to have a third child. I am done.
I think
all right.
Just
enough has been pushed out. I am done. We need a house.
Yeah. Where do you want to go? Down the shore? Up in the mountains? Garwood?
I want to be close to my family, but not same town close.
I don't know. Your brother-in-law and sister-in-law live right next to their mothers. How about Clark?
Yes, Clark is just far enough.
Oh. This house is beautiful.
What the hell's going on with the shrubs? And the grass? And the pool?
I want to go out tonight.
Oh, I'd love to.
I'd like to go see my brother-in-law and the cute guy Rich do a show. Have you seen my car keys?
They were with your diamond ring like 20 minutes. Sweetheart.
Why do you misplace everything I put down?
I didn't do anything. You put your keys down next to your diamond jewelry.
If it was where I left it, it would still be there. And we wouldn't be having this conversation in front of everyone.
I thought you loved my sense of humor.
To be fair, when we sleep tonight, turn that way, that way, day.
I have rotting teeth. What are you going? Is that a pillow? That doesn't
matter anymore. Give them a round of applause. Thank you very much.
It's almost like we knew you.
Sort of. I don't know how.
Joe and I made a few phone calls, and we got a real special treat. One of the greatest opera singers in the world came here to Crossroads. We told him, hey, listen, it's going to be like half packed. This is the place to be. And his agent misunderstood and thought he was going somewhere else. So he's here tonight. You may know him as Andrea Bocelli. He is, as you know, he is blind. So when you do applaud, applaud a little louder. Let's get a round of applause. Let's bring him up on stage first. There we go. Here we go, buddy. Now. Now, Andrea's going to sing one of his classics. Like I said, applaud as much as you want. This is special. It is coming. We brought in
Top Chef Norton, Top Chef.
We brought in the best sound guy in the business, people. You can't pay for this because we don't. I feel like we were there. Round of applause.
Che non ho mai
Okay, buddy. Okay. Enrico Palazzo, everyone. Give him a round of applause.
It's Andrea Bocelli.
Yes, his cousin's Andrea Bocelli. Now, I just want to thank you for coming. I know you can't see. We have about 14,000 people here, sir. To see you. I know only seven. It sounds like seven, but it's a lot.
I didn't know that. Yes, thank you for having me. It's a good time. Yes.
So let me ask you a few questions for the people. Yes. How are you feeling?
Oh, out of sight. I'm feeling out of sight, Rich. Really, I can't explain it. It feels good.
Oh, that's great. A lot of people, they don't know what the words mean to this song. Can you explain the words to everyone?
Not a single word, man. It's in another language. I've never even heard it before. I just memorized the sounds. You couldn't tell it by my lips, but I did.
I was completely shocked.
You're a good boy.
I'm over here.
Oh, hey.
Hey. I want to thank you for coming. Did you hit a lot of traffic?
I don't know. They tell me we did. It was a sitting and it was a moving and it was a sitting and then it was a moving. So I don't think so.
Who's Wheezy?
She's a bigger fat, a blacker woman who drive me around.
Are you sure? How do you know?
I'm pretty sure. I cop the feel every once in a while. I'm a hungry guy. I gotta tell you this, I'm a hungry.
What do you want to eat?
I don't know. They got a vending machine.
How do you know what you ordered?
That's what I'm saying. They got the buttons, got the little things on them. Like, I can always feel that, but I don't know what I'm ordering.
Why is there Braille on the ATM machines that are drive-through?
I don't know. I'm a never driving. The fat of Wheezy is.
You know what? You sing beautifully.
Oh.
You have a lovely voice.
Oh.
Magical.
Oh, thank
lovely.
You.
Lovely.
Yes. Where did everybody go? Is it 17,000 people?
How about this? I need your help.
Okay.
For this next game, we want to bring a lovely young lady on stage.
Okay.
And we're going to recite her a love letter.
Oh, that sounds like a fun.
It is. That's why we're doing it.
Okay.
You pick. You're going to help me out?
Absolutely.
Where can I possibly find a young lady? Oh, no doesn't mean you're not going to get picked.
She's not looking at it.
That's all right. Watch this.
Yo.
Oh!
Up here! A car!
Oh, yes, we would love a volunteer. Thank you. Give her a round of applause for coming up. Absolutely. There you go. You can finish chewing. So listen, here's what we're going to do. We are going to recite a love letter to you. But here's what's shocker. Your boyfriend John called me earlier in the week. He wrote a little ditty on a napkin, and he goes, listen, this are my feelings towards Betty. He goes, but I'm shy. He didn't know how to say it. He said, could you bring her on stage, recite this love letter to her? And we said, yeah, why not? You know, what else are we going to do tonight? So Joe's been memorizing this all week. Now, we can do it in any language in the world. What language in the free or communist world would you like to be recited a love letter to? Third world as well, just to think of something, living
Italian.
Or dead. Italian. Gee, where would that pop in your head? Italian. Do you know Italian? Okay.
You know it.
So we're going to recite you a love letter from your boyfriend John in Italian. Italian. Betty. John. Now don't judge us, people. John wrote the letter, not us. Betty.
Okay, Betty.
Okay, Betty.
Dite tu nia castagliana tu tonia cabiente, solo tonia la casa di ambiente. Corsonia la cattere pa da cerubia, ma la castagliana da noa.
Betty, I picture taking you to Rome, and when it just in our beautiful hotel room, putting the curtains to the side, looking at the beautiful view of this city that's still not as beautiful as you. Mwah. He's a sweet talker.
Betty.
Oh, Betty.
Faccia la bella fagnotta, se caratenta da Roma. Bella donugna, casaregna, la locosante. Bara signora, casare totogna, para casita, purpa. E signora, pa... Cazzonia la ravadegna, cazza marafaiù.
Sorry. Betty, what I love best is when we go to Roma, we're gonna go across the countryside, we'll go somewhere in a nice, quiet little village. We'll sit, we'll read poetry together as I make the sounds your mother makes when she laughs. Betty.
Terza rodogna casa tiene a nonna, casa brillante su toro cacente, poro sognare a casa rete non male a casa tiente. Ma poro sognare a casa rodogna scacciata. Adanta, per il succo torna a tazziento, poro cassene di tienda al pozzozzi, nella cassa tutta mia tazza, pure caccette. Voro scantetta di mia scarca, sono nella cassa pandanda. Voro cassene di caccia del viento, sono cacciata di sinistra d'ogno, se carcassata di mia muoce attaccante, arrivata di...
Abbetti. I still remember our first date. We had a little soup, and then we wanted to watch basketball. So we went to the Harlem Globetrotters. We watched it for a few hours. The one guy threw it in the air, and then he said, "What?" And then he came back, he caught the ball. He went over his side, he went this. And then he did the old move called, in the oven, no, in the oven, no. And then afterwards, we divided the check 50-50.
Betty.
Oh, Betty.
Oh, bella Betty.
Oh, Betty.
Dette da nonno casa tiene non rosso tiente, per la casa non ti tiene la casotte, ma la sotto non è carriera la casa tiene, c'è la casa non ti tiene, ma la casa non ti tiene, ma la casa non ti tiene, la casa se tocce. Per sotto non è da casa, non è una buscala, non è che per sette la nagnano cosette. Bello tu sogni alla fadigna, caro sotto non è ragazzetta, ma lo sotto non è ragazzetta. Non era cazzata, non ho le cazzate per niente. Oh, salegnata, per cosa segnala, non ho le cazzette. Beato, non ho le cazzate nella marciata, non ho le cazzate nella tedizia della zizia. Sono tutto cocce, ne vediamo tutto giro. Bella settina, non ho cosa di dire niente.
Agano!
Bella canola, casa nella canola. Bella, se ti hanno sgocciato la tatina, solo così è una tagliata. Ciò, bella il cartone, segnale, tatina, solo così è una tatina.
Oh, Betty, the only thing I can say is, if we ever get married, your mother's not moving in with us. Ladies and gentlemen, give Betty a round of applause. Joe and I are about to leave the stage real quick, but we know that when you see love letter, you're like, love is tough. So we have someone coming up to help you guys, give you a little advice about love relationships. So, hello.
We
are
the
world's
best
experts
on
love,
romance,
relationships,
and marriage.
Please
raise
your
hand
if
you
would
like
to
have
your
questions
answered
by
us.
Let's
start
with that.
Please.
Got nothing.
Thanks. Next
question.
Why don't girls like me?
Well,
there's
so
many
reasons
that
girls
don't
like
you.
Let's
start
with
your
hair.
It looks
nappy.
Most
girls
don't
like
you. Next
question.
Any.
You.
Me? I'm too old.
That
is
not
wrong. So,
I'm gonna hurt you.
Why doesn't my wife let me drink as much beer as I want?
Oh. Dump
her.
At
now. Next
question. Honey.
Last
question.
Why do men insist on talking about what they've done in the bathroom?
Well,
we
are
proud
of
our
accomplishments
because
it's
so
hard
to
top
that. Thank you, guys.
A lot of shows that we go to, they try and bring kids up on stage, right? They want to involve families. They want to have a kid-friendly show. It makes us better, marketing-wise, to have people go out and say, we can hire them for anything. So I decided that we should involve kids in the show. So I went to Rich and I said, hey man, I really want to bring my daughter up on stage. And he said, but I'm half the act, so I decided that we're going to bring my daughter up on stage. Give her a wild round of applause for my daughter, Maggie Carney. Say hi, everybody. Hello, Maggie. Say hi to everybody. This is Maggie Carney, guys. Ladies and gentlemen, hi, how are you? All right. Yeah, let us finish. Okay. Maggie, what do you think that you'd like to be performing? What do you think that you'd like to be performing for us this evening, young lady? Dad, it's going to be great. I'm going to do a three-song Frozen. Remember that? Remember we rehearsed it? Yeah. Is that what you're going to do? That's a really hard thing to do for a young lady. Oh, there was only one rule. Listen, you said you're gonna sing, right? We're going to do a three-song compilation. Remember from Frozen? You were like, oh, Dad, you're going to love it. Remember, you're like, huh. You wanna build a snowman? Do you wanna build a snowman? I never see you anymore. Come out the door. It's like you've gone away. Do you wanna build a snowman? Okay, bye. That was awesome, Margaret. Oh, that was great. Let it go, let it go. Turn around and close the door. Let it go, let it go. The cold never bothered me anyway.
really thought this was going to work. You should have seen her at home. Everybody came over. We were singing and dancing. And, oh, and you were dancing. Remember, you're like, the bees are a buzz. The kids are all blowing dandelion fuzz. And I'm going to do what snowman does in summer. With a drink in my hand. And my snow up against the burning sand. Probably getting gorgeously tan in summer. And then you were going to do the dance. Remember the whole. Ratatat, ratatat. Didn't work. I thought she would have been more into it.
She actually did better than you, Joe. I'm pretty proud of her.
Martin Carmen!
You know, it's a point where we're going to need a couple volunteers.
A bunch of them, actually.
Yeah, you know, like five or six. We're definitely going to need someone from the Cougar table to help us out. Vote amongst yourselves. Then again, I'll take all five. It doesn't
matter. Come on, all five. Why don't you girls come on up and play? It's girls tonight. Come on.
Yeah, there we go.
Nobody's going to see you. Nobody's going to see you. If I can sing and dance for Frozen, you can come on up here and play.
Besides talent scouts.
Put your hands together for the Cougar table, ladies and gentlemen.
Now, we're going to line you guys up. First one here and going back. Now, the concept of this game called Drawing a Blank, and if you haven't noticed, Joe and I were very, very sharp, except when we forget things.
Right.
Then we're not sharp at all. There reaches a point in our scenes where sometimes we forget what we want to say, and we draw a blank.
Draw a blank.
At that point, Joe or myself will raise our hand, and whoever's standing at the microphone will say the first thing that comes to your mind.
Right in front of the kids, you're going to say whatever comes to your mind.
Now, that's the only rule. Other than that, you can lead us in any direction. Don't even try to think too much. Spontaneous is best. So Ritu, jump right up there.
That's all you.
And you guys are going to line up right behind her. After she goes, Ritu's going to go to the end of the line. We just rotate you through. So it's nice and easy.
Should we do a practice one?
Yeah, I like practice ones.
Okay. Hey, Mac.
Yeah?
We're supposed to go away on vacation tomorrow, and I seem to have forgotten my...
Suitcase.
See? It's that easy, and then you just jump right up there.
Got, uh-oh.
Just so I know.
All six of them, ladies and gentlemen.
How close are we? How close?
3 months left.
3 months
left?
God, oh.
90 days.
90 days.
No, that's, so the chances tonight, I mean.
I actually went like that. Okay, whatever, don't get excited. Whatever comes to mind, take your time. Take your time. Whisper it. Say it to somebody else, whatever you want to do. Don't pee.
Right?
She peed a little.
That was me.
I think she's kidding.
So we are going to need a suggestion, and we want to do a science fiction movie. We're going to make it interesting, something that's never been done before. So we want... something crazy, like the day, you know, the earth turned into a spider, something absolutely, something tells me this is going to be good. Go.
Go. We're pointing at it.
Honey, I Shrunk the Kids.
Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. Imagine if we made that into a movie and then.
I don't think it would work. They'd want like 3 installments and put something in Disney. I don't think it would happen.
By the third sequel, it would be horrible.
Wonder if we can get Rick Moranis.
All right, we'll start with that, but give us a little something more so it's not exactly that movie. Mr. Carney.
Something made up.
You look like you have something bouncing around that brain of yours, sir. Yeah.
Mr. McMahon. Ed McMahon, ladies and gentlemen. Ed McMahon. Make up a movie, sir. Name of any movie.
The Day the Earth Stood Still.
The Day the Earth Stood Still. I got creative kids in my family.
I thought of Star Wars.
The Day the Earth Shrunk the Kids.
And the kids stood still.
The day the earth made the kids stand still. The earth made the kids stand still. You like it?
We're going with it.
Okay.
Now you guys know what you're doing.
Okay, got it?
Hold that in. Don't hold it in.
I don't know what's going on. There's some sort of sugar rush going on here, pal. There are kids just bouncing off the wall everywhere I go. In the park, they're everywhere.
It's like, Something happened to them. They're out of control. We need to slow them down.
Nobody's calming down. They're like on a massive sugar rush. Oh, I got an idea. Maybe if we take them out and do... If we do jumping jacks,
okay,
it'll wear them out.
All right.
Get your whistle. Grab your whistle. You're the gym teacher, okay? I'm gonna try and round them up. Kids, everybody over here! Shake your pee. There we go. Okay, we got their attention for a second, Mac.
We got it. They know the jumping jacks when I yell the word.
Okay.
Because every time, I taught them in gym class, once I yell the word,
Now
they will start doing jumping jacks.
Okay.
You ready?
Yep.
Now. All right, didn't work. Here's what we're gonna do.
Okay.
I went to the science lab.
Yeah.
I opened up one of these books.
Okay.
And supposedly it tells you if the entire planet is filled with jumping jacking, sugaring kids, you should...
Do cartwheels?
All right, you should do cartwheels.
We got a full calisthenic activity here. This is like eighth grade, and I love it. This is cool. Okay, cartwheels.
Rolling.
Okay.
Rolling.
What I like to do is I like to tuck and hold my knees. That's how I roll.
Wow. All right, here's...
I don't know how we're going to get in the cartwheel and do jumping jacks.
Here's what we're going to do. We're going to have to poison them all.
Okay, I'm fine with this.
All right, so when they go to eat their Skittles, what's really going to be inside is...
Help us kill the kids. Help us kill the kids. Help us kill the kids.
Yeah, Benadryl.
Benadryl.
I don't know.
Benadryl.
Okay, Benadryl.
All right.
Yeah.
So we get all these Skittles.
Okay.
All these Skittles. Skittles. Skittles.
Okay. I'm like the. Okay. Children, come have your candy.
These kids are weird looking. That one right there looks like a.
Chewbacca.
Oh, he's turned around. There he is. He is kind of cute, though. He won't stop hopping around. They're like, if nobody's eating the Skittles, they're already too sugared up.
If you tickle them.
Oh, get them right under the.
The pinky toe. Pinky toe.
I'm not touching that little Chewbacca foot, guy. That's my foot. Stop. That's my foot. Stop. That's my foot. Tickling's just aggravating them.
I just heard on the news the entire planet is covered with these kids. They're jumping around, being crazy.
I wonder if there's a space beam coming down from...
Mars.
All right, let's go outside. Take a look.
I don't see anything.
I don't know. There's Mars.
There's Little Dipper.
There's Jupiter, and there's...
Remember Disney World? These stars look beautiful.
Uranus?
Yes! There is another planet in the solar system, correct. Yes, thank you.
Get out of the window, Mom! Get out of the window!
Is that like a giant space shuttle? This could explain everything. This is not good. I am not happy.
Look, the doors are opening up. They're yelling something. They're saying...
They're saying, watch out. Watch out.
They're saying, watch out. Everybody's coming down to do jumping jacks and cartwheels. Look out. It's mayhem, cat sleeping with dogs. This is crazy. All right. We got to devise a plan to get up in that spacecraft right there and reverse the tractor beam.
All right. Well, right here in my handy emergency kit, I have a big giant
hammer.
Okay.
Nothing will stop an entire group of aliens taking over the planet like a hammer.
It will if we throw it right in their power thruster right there. If you aim for the...
Throttle.
You aim for the throttle right next to Uranus. Hook it right around right there. Hit the throttle, it'll come down.
All right. I'm ready for this.
Okay. One, two... Wait! Did you wear your...
Mantle?
You left it on the dresser. Of course I wore it.
You weren't picking up on my hints. I figured I'd put it next to your wallet and keys. You had no other choice. Sorry, let's get back to this.
All right.
All right. You're okay?
The planet may explode, and you want me to wear a man thong.
You look good in it, babe. It makes me excited.
At least it's clean underwear if I go to the emergency room.
What are you saying?
Okay, here we go.
Wait, what are you saying? You're saying that I never do?
Why do we have to fight now?
I don't care about the kids.
The planet is about to get destroyed, and you always have to bring
it. I have kids. They jump around all the time. I want to know about my underwear habits.
Well, it's funny, because last night in bed, when I turned to you and you said...
Where's my Speedo?
You said, where's my Speedo? And I'm like, it's right where you left it. You know what I mean? Because you forget where you put everything.
It obviously wasn't. I put it right next to your jewelry box. I know exactly where it was.
Right.
Yeah.
And I would have asked you, except your mouth was open and you're in my face and drooling all night.
Oh, I forgot about that. How come every time we come out here to battle aliens, you always...
That's a loud noise.
Laugh.
My emotions mean nothing to you. You and your man, I hate that. I hate that laugh. Can we get back to business now?
Oh, the aliens.
Okay, listen, I forgot to tell you. What? I have in the shed, I got a...
snowblower.
So you work with your stupid hammer. I'm gonna go over here with my Speedo and get rid of all this snow.
So we're back to Frozen. We're back to Frozen. When that thing breaks down, you're going to be looking for the hammer. You're going to be looking for this. You're going to be looking for this. You're going to be looking for this.
You want to build a snowman? Because you're going to need a friend. You're going to be sleeping outside tonight if you don't get rid of these jumping jack kids on our front lawn.
You know what? My mother is right. I should have married a...
Thank you very much.
Give her a round of applause. Give them a round of applause.
Good job.
You guys rock.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. You did awesome. Give it up for the Cougar table. 5.5 women of fun. Joe, we're
5.5 women of fun.
5.5 women of fun.
Sad.
I think we need to finish strong.
Okay.
Strong.
Did you guys have a good time tonight, everybody? We're going to leave you with our, this is probably our favorite game. Would you say it's our favorite
game? It's top seven.
Top seven. We need two volunteers. Two volunteers to come up on stage. We already did sound effects. And they just.
It's the last game, Sandy. Sit down.
I'm coming.
I don't want to get a jacket. I'm freezing.
How about this young lady up here that explained Frozen to you?
Is she going
to
be tall enough?
For you. We need somebody taller.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
All right, sorry, young
we need tall. That's
young lady in the back, in the pink. Would you like to come up and play with us?
Ladies and gentlemen, we got into comedy for
one
the
more,
groupies.
One more. We need one more.
Right here.
Come on, brother. Let's go. Come on. Whoever's pointing.
Jeff, there you go. Jeff.
Hi, what's your name?
Kathleen.
Oh, hi, Kathleen. Kathleen.
And we got a Jeff fan coming up.
Oh, nice. What's your name, brother?
Jeff.
Jeff.
Thank
Jeff
you, Jeff.
Is Kathleen.
You're
Kathleen,
tall enough.
Rich,
yes,
Rich,
you're perfect. You're perfect.
Doctor? Doctor?
Sir.
Okay. So how this is going to work is Rich and I are going to perform a scene for you, but we are going to be unable to move without the help of these two fine people behind us, Jeff and Kathleen. Jeff, you're going to move me. Kathleen, you're going to move Big Rich right there, okay?
You're so lucky girl.
How this is going to work is if you...
I love comedy. Sorry.
Calm down, I'll bring your mom up here. Listen. So if Rich wanted to move this arm, okay, and he's hinting towards it and he's speaking, move his arm, that's what you have to do to pick up his arm. If he has to put his arm down, you have to... Now, if he needs to walk, you got to smack... There you go. Have you seen our show before? There you go. Now, if he needs to come back, you, there it is. Okay, and if he... Right there. Okay. Same goes for me. There's only certain rules. We are human. It hurts. Just remember that. We're not here your playthings.
We're not your playthings.
First question before we get started. Sir, any time in history that you would love to go back to?
Revolutionary War.
The Revolutionary War.
Ooh, that's the one we won.
That's the... Okay, can you please put Rich in a position, any funny, awkward position to start? Jeff, you do the same to me.
Wait for
season!
Sir, I'm scouting. I see the British.
I can't seem to get my monocular over here to take a look at how far the British are away.
Oh,
the
sun is
in my eyes and I can't see through the telescope.
That's okay. I'm here to help. I am...
I can feel you. I just can't see you, General. General, I feel as I'm frozen in fear.
It's been frozen here at Gettysburg.
Where have you been? I was so scared. This is my aggravation pose, General.
I will hug you. I will give you strength. Oh, look.
No, it's too late for this, General. We are so deep in this war, General. That's not the war, General.
We have come so far, we don't even have
shoes. How do you know? Oh. Where is my horse? Sir, I'm sending hand signals.
I am doing the Lombada as a midget.
The gorilla's in the trees.
Why? I'm sending them.
You are so profound, General. Listen, I'm telling them they're a bunch of losers. Now I'm not.
No, don't do that. I'm going to stand here and think.
What? Over here. General, if you would just look over here. Here's your new horse.
Now I have a thought.
All the guys chipped in. We bought you this brand new horse, General. It's white. It's got fine teeth, beautiful ears.
I am behind you now, son. Very close behind you. It's cold out here, Ingrid.
It's freezing. I got 55 cows under this shirt. General, what will the men think? You are a commander and leader.
I have wanted this for years.
Why do you smell like my Uncle Mike, General?
Does he smell like rebellion?
No, he smells like beer and Old Spice.
That's how it starts. And now I'm a little teapot. Just like you like it.
General! We're in the middle of a battle, General.
Yes, there we are. A battle for your soul.
That's not my soul.
I just wish you would dance with me. I'll let you lead. You?
I'm embarrassed.
Love our uniforms.
I don't like the fact that we're playing shirts and skins against the British.
I just wish the red coats could match with the blue coats.
Sir.
Hi! Come over for tea.
Sir, I'm just not speaking to you. I'm in my Marsha Brady pose. I'm not speaking to you.
Yes, this is me. Oh. My teeth are made of wood.
I know, Paul Revere was yelling, your bridges are coming. Your bridges are coming. That was good.
Thank you, guys. Come on.
You're so awesome.
Good job,
very buddy. Nice.
Bring it
what
in,
are you doing after
in.
The show? Anything thank good? You. Anything fun? Want to get together after the show? Buy me a drink? Make
Joe,
out with me?
Joe,
oh, hey,
Joe.
Sorry.
Share to
get
me
was
your number.
Nice. I like that.
Ladies and gentlemen, can we get a round of applause for every volunteer that came up with us on stage tonight? You really got to break soup out of his show.
Yes,
very
both
shy.
My kids. I'm sorry that my daughter got stage fright.
No, no, it's about this way. We don't have to worry about it next time.
Yeah, next time we won't have to do it. Rich and I are going to be performing in Atlantic City, the Tropicana, July 30th. We are in the finals for a new talent contest at the Tropicana. If you guys want to come down
July
and see us, it's going to be
30th.
A big deal. July 30th. We tried out a bunch of new things tonight. I hope you guys liked it. We're going to keep working on it, delivering some shows. Rich and I are bringing the show on the road. Tomorrow night we're going to be in Bordentown, and then we got a lot of great things coming up. So,
absolutely.
Please give it up for my partner, the brains of this operation, the talent, the beauty, Mr. Rich McDonald.
The one and the only, Joe Carney.
Thank you guys very much.
Thank
hope you.
You
have a good time. Enjoy the rest of the night. Have some drinks. Take care of your waitresses. Guys, have a good night. Thank you for coming out. See you soon.